Yo, what is up you guys? My name is Benji and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're going to go over something that is near and dear to my heart, something that I really, really enjoy doing. We are going to go over how to sell a covered call, specifically on the Robinhood platform, since a lot of you guys are users of this platform, and specifically because I actually just got asked this morning from someone in our Discord server to really go over this, and it made me realize that I haven't went over this topic in a while. I made a video like a year ago on this topic, but this is very important to know how to do, and it's very helpful, so I wanted to go over it in detail, and what a better time than now. So let's go over how to sell a covered call on Robinhood. So first of all, some of the basics. If you don't have options enabled on Robinhood, you are going to have to go into your account settings and enable option trading. Also, if you don't have 100 shares or more, you are not going to be able to sell a covered call, because when you're dealing with options, you're always dealing with sets of 100 shares. Now, let's assume for this example in this video, let's assume that we have 100 shares of Apple. Let's say that we bought them today. So let's say we have 100 shares of Apple at $134 per share. And let's say that we want to go ahead and sell a covered call because we were interested in earning some premium. Perhaps you came across someone on YouTube like myself that I'm always talking about selling covered calls. I'm always showing off all the premium I'm earning. And let's say that you got to the point today, you officially have 100 shares of Apple at $134 per share. So at this point, what you'd want to do is, it's pretty simple. You'd want to type in whatever stock you want to sell the covered call on, which in this case is Apple. So type in Apple. We're already on this page. Go to Trade Apple Options. Now this brings you to the Apple Options page. This is very important, so pay attention to this part. We are going to be selling covered calls, so you always want to click on sell. You're going to be selling a call, so of course you want to be on a call. So make sure you're not on buying a call, because then on that case, you will be on the other side. You'll be basically paying the premium for the contract instead of earning the premium for the contract. On every side of an option, there's the buyer and the seller. So in this case, we are going to be the seller because we own the shares. And we're basically going to let someone else rent out our shares for the time being. And in return, they are going to be paying us a premium for doing so. So now that we have the Apple on sell, we have it on call, we are going to be choosing an expiration date. Now with Apple, the expiration date is every single week. With certain stocks, there is not an expiration every single week. Some stocks have an expiration date every month. And there's even some ETFs like the SPY ETF that have expiration dates every few days. But for most large cap stocks, you're going to see an expiration date every single week. Now, this is going to be very important to keep in mind, because things are going on in the market at all times. It's a very, very complicated stock market out there. For example, Apple reports earnings after the bell today, which just so happens to be the time I'm filming this video. So the expiration date for April 30th, which is in a few days from now, is going to be very important, because Apple is likely going to move at least a little bit within this range, because earnings normally do move a stock around a little bit. Now, if we choose a different date, let's say we choose like May 14th, May 21st, May 28th, you have to figure out, is there anything important going on? And this is also sort of an advanced, more deep level of this. This is not stuff I talked about in my first tutorial with option trading, but expiration date and timing is very important, because again, keep in mind things like ex-dividend dates, like earnings, maybe even times where there's new product releases, all these things in mind when it comes to choosing your expiration date. And it will be very helpful. And also keep in mind that you will see the pricing in there. So for example, this option expires in just a few days, but there's a lot of premium to be earned, because again, options chain is pricing in the chance of Apple moving around in price quite a bit because of earnings, of course. Where once again, if you pick a different date, maybe further out, just randomly, obviously it's going to be more expensive because it's much further out, but there might not be as much pricing built into it because it might not be as important of a date, if that makes sense. But just for this example, let's go ahead and choose expiration date April 30th, which again is in just a few days from now after earnings, because earnings is today after the bell on April 28th. So the next thing you want to do with your 100 shares of Apple that you own at $134 per share, because remember that's our example, $134 is your average cost, you want to go ahead and pick a strike price that you want to work with. So the strike price is basically the sticker price that you are willing to sell your Apple shares for if Apple does get to that price on or before the expiration date. So basically, when you're selling a covered call, you're hoping that Apple stays below the strike price, because then you'll be able to earn the premium and you'll be able to go on with your way. If the Apple share price does go above the strike price on or before the expiration date, there is a chance that the shares will be called away from you. You will then get paid out whatever strike price you choose times 100, because of course we're dealing in shares of 100 when we're dealing with options. So for this example, let's go with the strike price of 137, which means once again that I would be willing, as the owner of the Apple shares, to sell my 100 Apple shares for $137 on or before the expiration date of April 30th. And in return for putting up this option and for writing this contract, I will be earning $1.28 times 100, which is $128 or $129. So the other person on this option contract is paying you $128 to basically have you loan them out your Apple shares and giving them the option to utilize your shares if they want on or before the expiration date. So it's sort of like an agreement between you and the buyer. So there's not all that much more to it from there. The next thing you would do is you would click on whatever strike price you want. So let's click right here. It's highlighted. Now you would go to continue on Robinhood. You would type in how many contracts you want, and Robinhood shows you exactly, you know, how many shares are in each contract. It's 100 shares in each contract. So make sure you put in one contract if you're looking to sell a call on just one option contract. Now, let's say you have 200 shares of Apple or 300 shares of Apple. You could always do more. You could put in two for 200 shares or three for 300 shares, whatever you want to do here. But for this example, we only have 100 shares of Apple at $134. So we're going to sell a covered call at a $137 strike price, and we are going to earn $132 in premium. So next, what we do here is we type in the limit price. The lower the limit price is, the higher chance it's going to be filled right away. So in this case, I'd probably type in like 1.3 and just review and then continue, and it would probably get filled right away. Now, you could always go higher with the limit price when you have the chance of it not getting filled. It's the same thing as the bid and the ask when you're buying a stock in general. So I'm sure a lot of you guys are familiar with the bid and the ask and how and when a stock gets filled. This is basically the same thing. So from there, it's literally as simple as that. You're going to wait and see now where Apple moves until the expiration date. And once again, if Apple's stock price does go up and above $137 per share, your shares are in jeopardy of you losing the shares, but again, you'll be making a profit of a nice $300 on the actual stock price because you bought the shares at $134. The strike price is $137, so you're going to be making $300 off that on top of the $130 you're going to earn from the premium just for writing the contract. So selling covered calls is a super easy way to earn extra free money, literally. It's literally risk-free. The only thing you have to worry about is if Apple does go up above 137 to like 140, or let's say it goes to 145, well, the maximum profit that you can expect is only going to be so much because you're only going to be able to earn the amount of spread between your cost basis, which is 134 times 100, and the strike price 137 times 100, which is $300. Plus the premium that you're earning. And then the buyer, the person that bought this contract from you, will be able to profit from that point basically on until, you know, infinity if it goes up and goes up and goes up. So that's the only risk. Your profits are capped. But hey, profit's profit. And for someone like me that trades pretty conservatively, pretty risk adverse, I love covered calls because you're able to earn premium just by owning shares of 100 count of shares. And by consistently locking in covered call plays, you're basically just letting your shares work for you while you hold on to them in your portfolio. So worst case scenario, the share goes up much above your strike price and you're forced to sell them for a little bit cheaper than they actually are, but you're still making a profit, so it's all good. But guys, that's really all there is to it. That's how to sell a covered call on the Robinhood platform. The Robinhood platform is actually really good for options trading. I do have to admit, I use TD Ameritrade, I use Webull, I use all the platforms really. So I have a good idea about all of them, but Robinhood is a good platform to options trade on. The UX UI is really nice to work with and everything. But if that video did help you guys a little bit, I'd really appreciate it if you did give this video a big thumbs up, as well as leave any comments or questions down below. I'm more than willing to help more from here. If you guys have individual questions, make sure to hit me up on our Discord server, which is free to join. The link is down below in the description. So if you guys have any more questions about selling covered calls, let me know. But good luck to all you guys as far as that goes. Thanks again for stopping by, and I'll see you guys in the next video. And lastly, you guys, we do have a Discord server that's dedicated to investors like you. It's full of dividend investors, option traders, day traders, and much, much more. So join the Discord. The link is down below in the description. It's absolutely free to join, and I hope we see all of you guys in there.